Now we are going to read the first lesson from our supplementary reader, Vistas, The Third Level by Jack Finney. Walter Braddon Jack Finney was an American author. He had specialized in thrillers and science fictions. He has also written many short stories, novels and plays. His collection of short stories were published widely in his times. He had also written plays. His novels and short stories have been televised and adapted in films. Time travel had remained one of Finney's favorite themes. He had explored the same in many of his short stories and novels. This theme is given various angles and dimensions in one story of his after the other. It is explored either as a mission or an escape, either from future to present or present to past. Time, according to him, is a perception and a place to be. He often connects it to the disappointments of the protagonist with his life or the condition existing in his life or perhaps the problems of the times in which he is living. Here is the storyline of the third level for you. Charlie, the protagonist, is a 31-year-old resident of the New York City. He knew every place of the city he lived in like the back of his hand. He commutes to his office every day through the Grand Central Railway Terminus, which is one of the largest in the world. The Grand Central Railway Terminus consists of two levels of railways. The local or the suburban trains ply from the lower level, whereas the superfast and the express trains ply from the upper level. One day when Charlie was returning from the office, accidentally finds out a third level. Here is a short video depicting the grandeur of the Grand Central Railway Terminus. Spread over 49 acres, hosting 44 platforms and so many trains at two levels, basement and the upper level, and many subways, rams, did you hear that? Yes, rams take you from anywhere to anywhere across the Grand Central Terminus, not having you to take a single staircase. Isn't it an architectural wonder? That's not all. It guards many secret pathways and chambers. For example, M42 is the deepest basement substation, 10 stories below the street level, that doesn't show in any map. Platform 61 is yet another secret. It's a private railroad located right under the Grand Hotel Waldorf Astoria. It was meant only for the elites. It is said that the 32nd POTUS, Franklin Roosevelt, had used it for commuting between New York and Washington without being noticed. His car was said to be driving down the custom-made private train to Platform 61, from there on by a massive elevator which would take him to the Astoria Hotel right on top. The Grand Central Terminus, with all its secrets, had inspired a number of writers and remained a part of their tales. Finney too was one among them. Anyone would get lost in the maze of the Grand Central Terminus. There's every reason for Charlie, our hero, to have got lost too. Now let's read the story. Have you ever had any curious experience which others find hard to believe? Charlie was just an ordinary guy, but one day by mistake he discovered an extraordinary place, a place from another age. Let's read further to know how he found it. The presidents of the New York Central and the New York, New Haven and Hartford Railroads will swear on a stack of timetables that there are only two. Now here, New York, New Haven, Hartford Railroad was a very dominant railroad operated in the New England region of the USA from the year 1872 to 1968. This was a dominant railroad, and the transportation in it was controlled by two of its chief investors, Morgan and Mellon, who are referred here as the presidents of the railroad. The presidents of the New York Central and the New York, New Haven and Hartford Railroads will swear on a stack of timetables that there are only two. But I say there are three. Because I've been on the third level of the Grand Central Station. Yes, I've taken the obvious step. I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine, among others. I told him about the third level at the Grand Central Station. And he said it was a waking dream wish fulfillment. He said I was unhappy. Oh, that made my wife kind of mad. But he explained that he meant the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry and all the rest of it. And that I just want to escape. Well, who doesn't? Everybody I know wants to escape. But they don't wander down into any third level at Grand Central Station, right? But that's the reason, he said. And my friends all agreed. Everything points to that, they claimed. My stamp collection, for example, that's a temporary refuge from reality. Well, maybe, but my grandfather did not need any refuge from reality. Things were pretty nice and peaceful in his day, from all I hear. And he started my collection. It's a nice collection too. Blocks of four of practically every US issue, first day covers and so on. President Roosevelt collected stamps too, you know. Let me give you a quick explanation of whatever happened so far. Charlie, our chief character, finds another level of railroad which by no means exists. He consults his psychiatrist. He says it's only an illusion, as he was very unhappy like everyone else of his time due to war, fear and insecurity. Finding third level is like diverting oneself to things like stamp collection and so on.